Moreover, I have information from people intimately familiar with Reimer's practices that they are commingling and double billing and overbilling and committing ethical violations. Well, today, in addition to all that, I received a new Sixth Circuit case that definitively shows that homeowner, in this case, Patty Busby, has been getting screwed by the Ohio courts and Reimer Arnovitz.
Reimer Arnovitz is a law firm that recently lost, or settled, an employee discrimination lawsuit because they fired older employees so they could bring on younger employees with less experience and skill levels. Reimer Arnovitz is a law firm that just lost their motion to dismiss a claim of unjust enrichment just a few weeks ago. Reimer Arnovitz is a law firm that has been telling lies since 1977. The lead name partner was a goddamn liar back in 1977. And I quote, "The evidence relating to the affidavit to secure service on Mrs. Sims was so patently false that the trial court should have so instructed the jury." That's the kind of mentality we're dealing with when we deal with Reimer Arnovitz.
I am a former assistant state attorney in Ohio who has managed a title company and closed a couple hundred residential home sales. I am now an investigative journalist with a primary website entitled Mortgage Movies Journal. Okay? I also do deposition video, but that's another story. Now, Reimer Arnovitz is an Ohio-based foreclosure mill that is involved with Safeguard Property Management, the scum who are being sued by Illinois Attorney General Lisa Madigan and many other homeowners throughout the country for trespass, theft, and other matters. Reimer Arnovitz is the same foreclosure mill that was questioned about U.S. return receipt green cards. In a case involving the Busby family, those green cards appear to be completely forged. Patty Busby, I'd like to speak with Attorney Peter Costello, please.
Okay, is this regarding Neville? Okay, I tried to get a hold of Pete Costello, but he wasn't in his office. Did you want to leave him a voicemail?
I do, yes, thank you.
Okay, one moment, please. Do you know if he'll be there later today?
You've reached the office of Peter Costello.
Concerns that I have in her case, which is scheduled for sale tomorrow, are that there are green cards in her file that were used for service, apparently. They were filed in the court, and there's an affidavit in the court now with Jimmy Busby claiming that those signatures are not his on those green cards. I have reviewed the signatures, and they appear to be materially inconsistent between each other. There are two green cards, and then they are inconsistent with his affidavit signature as well, so I'm concerned about that. I'm also concerned with the fact that the sheriff claims that he personally served Patty Busby when she was in the hospital at the time and had undergone gastrointestinal surgery and eye surgery. He was basically blind at the time. And plus the fact that if he personally served her, why are those green cards in the file indicating service of some kind? So there's an allegation of fraud. I can't substantiate it, but I'd like your comment on it. And given those allegations, I'd like to know if you're willing to suspend this sale. I have a notation that you prepared an assignment involving Mohit Pathan, who allegedly was a vice president of MERS. Sir, I have no indication that Mohit Pathan ever worked for MERS, and that appears to be a false allegation on your part if you prepared that assignment. And again, these are material issues involving the chain of title, and I'm wondering if you're willing to suspend this sale given these allegations. Now, this matter has implications that go well beyond any court litigation underlying this whole matter, so parallel jurisdiction most certainly exists for the bar associations to look into this, if they will. And when you go back and look up the green cards, they track to nothing. So the courts are ignoring it. Will the bar association ignore it as well? Arnovitz, by the way, has now removed Rachel Kuhn, herself a former foreclosure defendant, from this case and appointed one Brett Housley. Now, this was after I demonstrated that Rachel Kuhn lied to the Columbus Bar Association about why the firm refused to speak to me when I called them as an investigative journo. Okay? She lied and said it was because of FDCPA privacy concerns, but Ms. Busby had executed a confidentiality waiver and actually accompanied me on the telephone when I called Reimer. So they're full of shit. So now, anyway, Housley has now filed a precipice for sale and all that, but he's going to have to face the music from the Sixth Circuit, which now confirms everything Busby has been saying about the false assignment manufactured by Mohit Pathan and Reimer's own F. Peter Costello, in the Slorp versus BoA case. Here's the biggest single sentence from Slorp, and I quote, "Because Slorp alleges that the assignment was fraudulent and that Bank of America therefore did not hold title at the time of the foreclosure, Livonia Properties does not bar his suit. In fact, it supports it." End quote. Now that is precisely what Ms. Busby has been arguing all along, and I believe related issues may be extant in the still-pending Ohio Supreme Court case involving the Cookta case. Now, perhaps the Ohio Supremes were waiting on Slorp to rule on the Cookta case. I don't know. We'll see. Now, meanwhile, I'll let you read some key passages from Slorp.
All right, you wanna go?